guys. How's everybody doing today? Sorry for today's short notice on the video. I was gonna start painting this and then I realized that it would probably be a good one to go live on for you guys. Hopefully today I'm able to see comments. The last couple of videos I haven't been able to see any comments. And I don't like that. Say hi as you come on, please. That way I know somebody's watching. And if you're watching the replay, it's okay. I know this wasn't a planned live for me, so I didn't give anybody a notice. I just thought you guys might like to see me painting this, so. Right now I'm just base coating, and if you see, I am base coating with black. I'll go ahead and put my camera down a little bit so you guys can see what I'm doing. Sort of. These are kind of a little bit large, so it's hard to get it all on camera, but I'll try to move it up as much as possible so you guys can see. Right now, like I said, I'm just base coating everything in black. Kind of doing my edges too while I'm at it. Well, hello everybody. Who's here? I cannot see who's here, so I'm sorry if you're commenting and I haven't been able to say hi to you or anything, because for some reason Facebook has not been allowing me to see my comments until after my live, so I don't know what the deal is with that. know, this is kind of a little bit boring. This is just a black base coat. Okay, got it all with one rough little base coat of black. I know it's a little bit strange to do black for angel wings, but that's what I want to be in the background, so I start with the black. I'm gonna go ahead and dry this coat really well. Try to go slow on this a little bit, but if you guys have any questions, I don't see any comments right now, so I don't know if anybody's talking to me or not, but if you have any questions on anything, please let me know and I'll go back and answer. This is kind of the look that I'm trying to achieve. So if you can see, I went ahead and base coated the black. I started with the black layer, and then I kind of layered on the white on top of it. So it's actually, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4 colors layered up on top of that black. So it's 5 colors total. Hopefully you guys can see that. I started with the black, and then I'm gonna go in and do like a gray layer, and then I went back in with a white, and then I added a little bit of turquoise and a little bit of gold to it as well. So that's kind of what we're gonna be doing today. That was just me playing around with it and making sure that's the look I wanted to go for. So the brush that I'm gonna be using is this brush right here. It's pretty big. It's a Filbert, and it doesn't have, well, it's a three-quarter inch Filbert is what I'm using. So I don't know, I don't think I have any others that are that big, only flat brushes and all that. So this is the one that I want to be using because I kind of want the rounded edge on it. So I really like the Filbert for that. For this one right here, the sample that I did, I used, see if this one says it, a size 8, and this one's like a, probably like a half inch, and that one's the one that I got this look out of, like this. So it's about a half inch. So now I'm going to be moving up to this one right here, and this is the 3/4 inch right here. So I have the color I'm using next is the granite gray from Apple Barrel. It's the lightest gray that I have, and I want it to be light. So even if I wanted to, I could probably actually add a little bit of white to it, and I might still do that just to kind of, you know, get it lighter on that coat. I don't want it too dark, but you're gonna want to start down here at the bottom. You're gonna start with the bottom of the wing, and we're gonna work on one wing at a time. So I'll be moving my camera around a little bit so you guys can see it better, but we're gonna be working on one wing, and then I'll switch it up to the next one. So you're gonna want to load up your brush with your paint. And what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to do long strokes. And you see where these little scallops are at the end? I don't know if you guys can see that, but these little scallops are where the feathers kind of end. So right here, we're going to be making like a row. So I'm kind of trying to picture where, and you can use chalk if you want to. I'm not using chalk, but if you want to, you could kind of map it out just a little bit so that you know where to end with your paint strokes, if that would make it easier for you. Let me see if I have a piece of chalk here handy. I don't have anything handy. If not, I would show y'all. But anyway, so you're just going to want a picture, more or less, where you want your strokes to end. So me, I want that stroke to kind of end right here, this bottom part, because the feathers on the angel wings are a lot longer on the bottom part. So since I already have all my paint on here, I'm gonna start from the very bottom tip and kind of work my way up, and then there I'm just gonna kind of flare it out like that. I want it to kind of be a little bit more see-through to the top. So I'm just going to kind of flare it up just like that. But it's, if you notice, it's a long continuous row or feather. Like, it's not anything like broken up or anything. So then again, I'm going to start again down here at the bottom and start again and kind of just end it. Kind of, I want it to kind of be broken up here at the top. Same thing here. I'll go all the way up. See that? There we go. So that's the bottom. And this is using the gray as my base coat. So it's just like a really, really light gray. And you can definitely see where it's broken up right here. I kind of want it to look more like hair or feather-like. And I want that black to kind of peek through the bottom as well. So I didn't cover all the little gaps because I still want that black to peek through in between those. So then now I'm going to start on my second row, which this little scallop right here is my second row. I don't know if you guys can see that part very well, but let's see. Here's where my hand is. Here's the scallop right there. This is going to be much shorter. And it's going to be right along this area here. So I'm just going to kind of go across on this one. This one I kind of went up just a little higher, but this time I want to cover up just a little straighter, if that makes any sense. And the same thing, I just load up my brush and kind of start at the bottom and kind of go up. If you need it, there we go. And then I'm gonna put mine, since this one starts down here, I'm gonna kind of start it down here as well, kind of lower below where this ends right here. Like, I kind of want it to cover up some of that right there. Okay, so it's gonna start right there. You want the feathers to kind of overlap each other just a little. And the same thing, short strokes, but I kind of want to wisp it out just at the top a little bit. And it doesn't matter if you overlap or if you kind of go in between. Like right here, there's a little gap in between. It's fine. You could still go ahead and add another one in there. There's no numbers to these. Like, they're, it actually looks better when you kind of do the feathers. When you kind of do the feathers, like, where they're not matchy-matchy, or when, you know, it's like a little bit messier. You don't want it to be too uniform. There we go. That's our second row right there. I hope this is making sense for you guys. Now I'm going to start up on this one right here. Let me move this down just a little. And you can see this section right here. This is this one right here. And I'm gonna go across. So this one, I'm gonna end it probably right here in this middle part, because then once I start working on this side, I can connect them. So this one's not gonna be, I'm not gonna go all the way across for this one, just kind of right here in the middle, okay? So, but it's the same exact thing. Let's see if I can work where I can, where you guys can see it too. Hopefully y'all are able to see that part. Okay, there we go. Now you guys can see all those layers. Now if you need to go back and kind of add to some of them, just kind of at the bottom, like this one was kind of a little bit short, I feel. So I'm gonna add to it just a little more. There we go. I think that looks better. There we go. Okay. And you can push it to the top. Let me go turn my light on. Maybe that will help a little bit. I know this is black background, so it's hard to see. Is that better for you guys? Hopefully. You're kind of wanting those little gaps in there, in between. And you're wanting to just wisp them out so that they look like feathers. They look light. There's that row. Now this very, very top part is also the same. Except this one, you're going to want to go towards the inside. You're kind of working towards the inside of the wing, so. There we go. There's a whole side right here. Hopefully you guys can see that. There we go. And these are just, it's another layer of paint that I'm adding. So this is the gray one on top of the black. And I'm still gonna be going over it with white, because I want my wings to be white. The only reason I'm doing all these layers is because I do want the dimension. And I like the way multiple colors look without having me go back and adding you know, highlights or lowlights or anything like that. This is kind of working backwards, you know, from the back to the front. But I feel like the effect is really pretty. And I just like it because it makes it look like soft and airy. You know, when you go back and add highlights to it, sometimes it can make it look a little bit too heavy. But this way, since I'm kind of dry brushing it in a way, just by the strokes that I'm doing that are long and kind of broken, it kind of makes it look airy, if that makes sense. So I'm gonna start again on the very bottom and you work your way up. So same thing on this side. And I'm gonna try to keep the both sides to kind of be similar. I mean, of course they don't have to be exact, but I do want the line where the feathers start to be about in the same area. So of course these little scallops are what I was using to kind of measure that. And so that's kind of what I'm gonna be doing the same. I'm just gonna kind of try to sort of mirror what I did on one side to the other. Here's my second row right here. This one's gonna go up just a little more and it's gonna go into this one right here. So I'm gonna start here and I'm sort of gonna go all the way to this peak. So there's that one. Now we're going to be moving on to this third section. Here. So it starts like right in here, going from here to here. And then that one's gonna go up into this right in here. So I'm kind of trying to merge these two together because I want them to blend kind of seamlessly, so. That one had a paint booger. Thank you. go. There's that. There we go. Now we're going to go ahead and merge these two together right here. I'm going to start from back here. There we go. Okay. There's our piece right here, right now. This is with the gray layer. Now I want to add a little bit of white to the top of it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be going over this gray with white. And that's just going to make it pop. But it's also going to give some of these low lights that I wanted in between as well. Let me dry this real quick. Now I'm going to be going over it with the white and same thing, but I'm going to be going over these black pieces, and I'm not going to go all the way up until, you know, the other feathers start. I kind of want to concentrate just on mainly just on the tips, and I'm gonna feather it up to the top. I like the gray to kind of be sort of a shadow, and so that's gonna make this kind of look like a little bit of a shadow, like the transition between the two. It's gonna make it look more like a little shadow, like if the feathers are actually on top. Okay, so same thing, I'm just gonna be using white, but going over my gray. And that's just to kind of highlight it, highlight a lot of the areas and bring up that white. Kind of dry brushing it in. And now with the white, I'm also going back and kind of dry brushing over the harsh black that's still left in the background a little bit. So once I set down where I want my white, I kind of just sweep it up on top of that gray and kind of just dry brush it in, up and down, just kind of dry brush it. But I'm still leaving this gray area right in there just for the shadow. Okay, there's my white. Same thing with this one, kind of just dry brushing. Sort of highlighting what you already have on there, but I want them to pop, so the white just kind of makes it stand out. If you notice, I'm kind of going back and forth because I do want them to kind of be a little bit wispy. I don't want them to be like perfectly round. So just kind of dry brushing them and making them a little bit messier. This is actually a really easy sort of technique, just because it's pretty messy, and you have like freedom to just put the strokes wherever you want, or add as much as you want, or not add as much as you want. Like, I could have probably left it alone at the gray, but I wanted to add all these colors to it and just make it pop more. I think the messier, the better they look. As long as you can see the little clusters of feathers, I think it looks great messy. Toning down that black as well, so just with the dry brush, just kind of toning it down. Don't want too harsh of black underneath, but I do want it to kind of peek through in some areas. So there we go. I feel like that's good. You can sort of see the difference in both sides. This one looks a lot more harsh with the black. This one's already a little bit more soft. You could still see the gray in between and then the white highlight on top, but you could still see some of the black peeking through, but it's a lot softer than this side. wrapping up all my black. Ooh, no. Let's see. Saved it. That would have been bad. There we go. There's that. Now you can leave yours like this, depending on the look you want to go for. You know, you can leave yours like this, or you can do, you can add more colors like I am. I'm gonna add a little bit of turquoise and a little bit of gold to mine just to kind of break up the white. I don't want it just kind of too white. So, but it's optional. Like, this is a project that can go many different ways. I wanted to do this. So if you can see, I have a little tiny peak of turquoise and also some gold throughout. And that's kind of what I want to go for today. It's not going to be much, but it's just kind of a little bit of fun. A little bit of fun and funkiness to these wings. So the color that I'm using, it's really not turquoise. It's called Caribbean. It's Apple Barrel. It's kind of a blue, like a bluish turquoise. And I'm also going to be using, the same brush. I feel like that one worked really well. I could probably go with a smaller brush. And you know what? Yeah, maybe I am going to go with the smaller. I'm going to be using this one right here. That's number 8, which I feel like it's about a half inch or maybe a little less than a half inch. But it's still a filbert. And I'm just going to be using it sort of like a dry brush as well. So I may switch to the bigger one just depending. But I don't want a lot of this color on my brush. So I'm just kind of dabbing off most of the paint. And I'm just going to go through and add a little bit of this to throughout the whole piece. So it doesn't matter where. I'm just going to kind of be placing it in random little spots. This is just kind of for fun, just to bring an extra little bit of color to this piece, but also just kind of lightly. Like, I don't want to add too much of it. Just kind of a fun little pop of color here and there. That's it. That's all I'm adding to it. Not a lot, but you can definitely see the pop of color that it gives. And then with my same brush, I'm going to be doing the gold, and I'm going to be doing it in the exact same way. I like adding metallics to pieces like this because it just kind of brings it a little bit, I don't know, metallics always, for me, it's just like a fun pop of color. It catches the light in a certain way sometimes, and so it just kind of brings it out just a little more. It's just fun. You could also do this with like a silver. It doesn't have to be a gold. The silver would actually look really pretty as well. If you're not a fan of gold. Picking random areas to put the gold in. I'm not really being too strategic with it. There we go. I think that's all I'm gonna do. But as far as this tutorial goes, this is it. This is all I had to do right now. That's all I'm gonna be painting on these angel wings. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And if you guys have any questions, please just let me know. I'll try to go back and answer all my comments. I couldn't see anybody's comments today, so. Yeah, if you have any questions, I will get a good, I'll get this sealed up and, I'll take a good picture of it, so you guys can see the whole finished thing. I know it's a little bit large and I can't get it all in the camera, so that way you guys can see the whole finished piece. But thank you guys so much for watching. Those of you that were here, and I'm sorry, I just came on kind of random. I do that a lot. I'm pretty random. I don't have a set time ever for anything. I just work whenever I feel like it. So, so yeah, I'll get this, posted up for you guys. And, once I get it all sealed and everything, that way you guys can see the whole finished picture. Hope you guys liked it, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.